the way to the lake. Work in the furniture factory, maybe watch, and we just give an easy figure to make the calculations easy. So we say something like 30 rand an hour. What would be an hourly rate? Would 30 rand sound like a
20?
That's under the minimum wage they commit. Oh, let's make it. We can make it 20 if you want to. So the worker is earning 20 rand per hour. How much does that give us per day from the employment if she's working 9 hours a day?
180.
180. So it's 20 rand per hour, 180 rand per day. Okay. Okay. What time does she start working in the morning, Robert?
7.
She starts working at 7.
So 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11. How many hours is it, Robert? 10 to 12. 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock.
Simunye starts at 7 o'clock in the morning. She makes chairs. If you take a chair like this, complex, what are all the raw materials that you will need in that chair? You need wood. The raw materials. So you need wood. What else would you need, complex?
Glue.
You need glue. Okay. Nails. Varnish?
Sandpaper.
Sandpaper? That's a new question. You need some sandpaper. What else? What else would you need to get? This chair. You need tools. Let's put machine maybe, just same thing. Machine is a tool. You need for some machine, you might need it to cut the top. You might need to cut the wood. Anything else? What's the most important thing that we're leaving out of this? What do you need to make this chair?
Hopefully when all is said and done, you still have your chair.
The raw materials plus the labor.
144.
How much more?
144.
Okay, so all of the cost of one chair for the boss is 144. For the boss, the cost for the chair is 144. Now, colleague, the one you were quick to answer that one, you wanted to answer that one. Well, if they sell the chairs to Macro, if they supply Macro with chairs, and if you want to go shopping now, you must go to Macro, or to go to Game, will they sell it for 144 to Macro?
Mm-hmm. No.
What's the price likely that, not that you will buy it from, at Game or Macro, that the company, we didn't give the company a name, Freedom Fashions, or something like that. If they sell it to Macro, what are they likely to sell this chair to Macro for?
Come?
I think it's 900
bucks, including tax and
debt. Okay. Comrade says 900 bucks. If comrades feel maybe that's a little bit high, even if you halve that, just for our example, even if you halve that and say, okay, they sell it for, say, 450. Comrade Raymond, if you can you work out for us the difference between what the cost was of that chair, the 144 rand, and what they're selling at 450 rand? What is the difference?
$306.
So, comrade, the bosses have started out with something that cost them 144 rand. But they end up getting 450 rand, which means they've ended up with something that is now worth more, 306 rand worth more than when they started. The question now comes is, where did that 306 rand come from? Where did that 306 rand come from?
Labor.
Yeah. If the worker didn't make the wood and the glue and the nails into the chair, largely into the chair, would that, the wood and the glue and the chair, still be worth, would that be worth 450 rand? What would it be worth? It would be worth 144 minus the labor of the workers, which is 40 rand. It would be worth 104 rand. That's what the raw materials was getting to. With the labor of the worker cost the boss 144, they end up with something that is now worth 450 rand. So by the worker turning the wood and the glue and the varnish and the nails into a chair, come let's call it products. By the worker turning the raw material into a product, which is the language Comrade used here, by turning these raw materials into products, by adding their labor, by working on it, the workers have made new value for the boss. The boss started out with a value of 104 rand, but by the worker working on that chair for 2 hours, on that, those raw materials for 2 hours, the boss ends up with a new amount, an added value of 306 rand. I don't know if comrades have questions about that. But let's just come back before comrades and everyone to think about the question. We said Simunye starts at 7 o'clock. She works till 8 o'clock, she's made half a chair. By 9 o'clock, she's made one chair. In that time, she's worked for 2 hours, and she's now made one chair, which has created profit for the boss of 306 rand. Okay. What is Simunye's wages for the day? We agreed was her wages for the day is, what did you say, Gomez? 180 rand for the day. She's just now produced profit to the boss of 306 rand. So before even she's finished working the 2 hours for the day, she's already covered her wages for the entire day. Her wages for the entire day is 180. She's now created, by just making one chair in 2 hours, she's covered her wages for the day, just like a recollection. She works for an hour and she's covered her wages. The question now is, does the worker knock off at 9 o'clock? She doesn't knock off at 9 o'clock. She works for another, how many hours, commits? 6 hours, how many hours? 7 hours, is it? Now she's made, in the next 2 hours, she makes another 306 rand profit to the boss. And in the next 2 hours, she makes another 306 rand profit to the boss. And in the next 3 hours, she makes another 306. And in the last hour, she makes half of that. 153 rand for the last hour that she works. Now, how much is that all together for the day? 306 times 3 plus 153 rand. She's made about 1,000 odd rand extra for the day. After she's covered her wages for the entire day here, she still works on other than for the boss. So for this time of the part of the day that she works, she covers her wages for the whole day. But she can't knock off at 9 o'clock. When she made an agreement with HR that she's going to work in this furniture factory, she didn't say she's going to work just to cover her wages. She agreed to work certain hours. She said, I'll work from 7 o'clock till 4 o'clock. So even though she's covered her wages for the entire day in the first 2 hours that she works, she then has to work for the rest of the day for Mahala. And as Colette says, in the first hour she probably covers her wages for the month. Not just for the day. You cover your wages for the month. And that's how this process then works. This is the time that the worker works to cover the wages. This is the time when the worker makes profit to the boss. And that really is then how this system works. Now, this is the complex, it's not strictly speaking the time, it's even earlier than that the workers covered their wages for the day. But if we agree that it's after 2 hours the wages are covered for the day, it's slightly earlier. If we agree that, what happens if the worker demands higher wages? What will happen to the profit of the boss? If the worker demands higher wages, where will this line go when the worker works to cover their own wages? Will it go that way or will it come this way? So, it will go this way. Yeah, if the worker is demanding more wages, then must the workers working for a longer period of time in the day to cover their own wages? And how does that affect the profits of the bosses? Do they get more profit or do they get less profit? They get less profit. If the boss decides that the worker must make a chair in 1 hour, they introduce a new machine. It cuts the wood more quickly and does the gluing itself. If the boss introduces a new machine to make the worker make a chair in 1 hour, for example, what happens to this line? Does it move now this way or does it move that way? In other words, yeah, the boss then makes more profit. Then the line shifts that way. If the boss uses a labor broker who gets in of a permanent, what happens to that line? If the boss is using a labor broker who gets in of a permanent worker, what will happen to this line? Yeah. There's been less time that the worker works to cover their own wages because the worker's wages is lower than the worker of a permanent. They say sometimes as much as 50%. You do exactly the same job as the permanent worker next to you, but you get 50% of the wages. Who benefits out of that? It's not the permanent worker, it's the employer who benefits out of that. Now there are a couple of questions. I don't know if that, you know, the makes a little bit of sense of comment of how this profit system making works. There's a lot of issues that we can add here, but for reasons of time. There are a couple of questions we must ask. The first one, obvious one, is if it is that the boss is paying us only for part of the time that we work in the day, what is that wages for? What do they pay us wages for? Is it for the work that we do the whole day? Is it for that? Let's see. Yes, Paul.
The money that they pay us is for us that we can be able to come back tomorrow to come and work again.
Okay. Because if they had to pay you for all the work if they had to pay you for all the work you've done, then they must give you all this money. But they keep that money for themselves, that's their profit. Yeah. So they're not paying us for all the work we've done for the day. They're paying us only for part of the day. But then as the thing is, as Comrade Busiso says, they pay you so that you come back to work tomorrow and they can exploit you again. But it still asks us the question then what is wages for? What are you paying wages? How do these bosses work?